Griffith will keep the puck in. Griffith. Griffith with another shot. Goal! Taylor Griffith from the blue line. Played in the slot. Goal! Afternoon, Forster fans. We welcome you back to Alumni Memorial Fieldhouse for the second game in the two-game home opening conference series against the Concordia University Wisconsin Falcons. The Foresters are coming off of a 4-2 win in last night's game. Mackenzie Cam, Amy Buddy, Christina Belomo, and Megan Lake scored for the Foresters. Jordan Trapp and Julia Untersayer had two assists. Amanda Beaujolais, Belomo, and Olivia Upsall had assists as well. Emily Godwin scored an unassisted goal for the Falcons. And Falcons' Maddie Millar scored a goal with an assist by Izzy Bilton. The Foresters are now 1-2 overall and 1-0 in NCHA play. Yesterday was the first win for first-year head coach Jennifer Wilson, who is coming off of an overall 13-11-2 coaching record with NCAA Division III Buffalo State. First-year assistant coach Sonia Novak is coming off of an overall 9-17 coaching record with Robert Morris University for the American Collegiate Hockey Association, Division I of the Central Collegiate Women's Hockey Association. Foresters are starting the 2018-2019 season with seven new players, starting with number one from Thunder Bay, Ontario, goaltender Samantha Stubbs. Number nine, a transfer from Adrian College and part of the 2017-2018 Slats Cup Championship team, and Northville, Michigan native forward Mackenzie Cam. Number 10, a Norwich, Vermont native defenseman Rose Sperry. Number 18, a defenseman from Duluth, Minnesota, Olivia Upsall. Number 19, a Brookfield, Wisconsin native forward Grace Black. Number 22, a defenseman from Edina, Minnesota, Megan Truman. And last but not least, from Savage, Minnesota, number 26, forward Abigail Tucci. Amy Buddy returns to the Foresters as a second-year captain, and Lexi Morgan, who was the leading goal scorer in the NCHA last season, has been named as first-year assistant captain and notes that she considers this to be a huge honor. The Lake Forest College Women's Hockey would like to show support for the Hockey is for Everyone campaign by reaffirming its commitment to providing a safe, positive, and inclusive environment for players, coaches, and families, regardless of race, color, religion, national origin, gender, disability, and sexual orientation. We will have puck drop shortly, but we will be starting with our starting lineups, and here come the Foresters. I'm Natalie Beaubrown, play-by-play. Have the face-off in their offensive zone. That's Harshman. Davis plays the puck. Opportunity here. Yandova comes all the way out. Opportunity for Morgan on the goal. Yandova misplays the puck, and Morgan ties it up. Trapp comes the other way, passes it up to Davis, and it's offsides. Great momentum by Davis and Trapp.
Absolutely. And I wanted to make another point about number six on St. Norbert, Jessica Schlapp. I actually, she played for the Keweenaw Storm growing up. They're a team in the Upper Peninsula of Michigan, a double-A team. And when I played for the Grand Rapids Griffins in Michigan, that was our rival team. And we got knocked out of state playoffs by them. And I actually got to know a few of the girls on the team, and she was one of them. So
what can we expect from Schlapp?
Just pretty much the same as Laura Michael, just a fast player and just knows how to get to the net. So she's always dangerous when she's out there.
And we saw Schlapp, she had four goals against the University of Wisconsin, Stevens Point. She's been phenomenal for the Green Knights thus far. And in yesterday's game, she had a few opportunities. Foresters come away with a puck. Long pass from Belomo. Now number 22, Stafford, plays the puck against the boards. Davis pries the puck away from the boards, but Wallace comes away with the puck for the Green Knights. It's going to be Beaujolais jousting for the puck. Shot on net, and that was Black. It's Grace Black, number 19, from Brookfield, Wisconsin. Puck is turned aside by Erard. Foresters keep possession of the puck. Black keeps the puck at the blue line. Now the puck is turned aside. Foresters come away with it. Here comes Morgan. Beaujolais plays the puck.
And the Foresters, like a power play out there.
It looks like a power play. The Foresters are doing a great job. Black with an opportunity. Black plays the puck at the blue line. Beaujolais with a shot, and it's turned aside. Foresters keep it in, and that was Untersayer with a long shot from the blue line. Olsen with an opportunity to get the puck out of the Foresters' offensive zone for the Green Knights. Here comes Untersayer, long pass to Beaujolais. Beaujolais settles the puck down, brings the puck along the boards. Erard stops the puck, and now the Foresters have a poke check, but the Foresters are unable to settle the puck and keep the puck in their own zone. Here comes Trapp over the blue line, wheeling it through the neutral zone. Simone wheels it through traffic. And Trapp will come away with the puck. Passes it to Fanning, who had an opportunity last night. Two, one short, and it's a goal!
All right.
And the Foresters are on the board.
What a beautiful play.
And that was Sydney Simone.
Yep, that had the whole team involved with that one, too. That was a great goal.
And can you take us through that play? What worked? And how, can you take us through the development of that play?
Zone, like getting everybody involved, not just trying to do it yourself. And then eventually the rebound came out and Simone put it home. So love to see it.
We have to keep seeing more team involvement. Everyone has to have their stick on the puck. I think that's what worked. Everyone pitched in.
Absolutely. It's huge to get on the board first too.
And it's always that momentum builder. Get on the board first and score that first goal. A good poke check by the Foresters. That could have been a dangerous play.
You can just see how calm Julia Undersayer
is. Oh, goal!
There we go.
And that was...
Is that Tucci?
That was Tucci, her first goal.
Somebody grab that puck. That's the first goal of the Forester. We were just talking about Tucci. She's been unreal recently.
I believe that's her first goal.
Yeah, buddy just grabbed the puck, yep. So it's her first goal.
First goal for Tucci, and Erard did not see that puck at all, yep. And Tucci just poked it in.
That's huge. I remember the feeling of having your first goal as a Forester. Nothing like it.
I remember your first goal, too. First home game of your freshman season.
Wasn't it against St. Norbert's as well?
It was against St. Norbert's,
yeah.
A lot of special things happen against St. Norbert.
Absolutely.
After the first period, we had a tie 0-0. We still have a tie 0-0. We will be back in about 2 seconds with our very own Mackenzie Cam. We are back with Mackenzie Cam. Mackenzie, first of all, how are you feeling?
You know, a little beat up, but I should be back and ready to go next weekend.
So last week you had a hard crash, but you were able to come back. What is this team doing? You've played with them. You have a lot of freshmen, younger players. How are they adjusting so far?
Yeah, we definitely have a younger team. We have a big freshman class coming in, so there was definitely a lot of growing pains in the beginning of the year. But especially after we got back from Maine, we kind of flipped that page, and we're really gelling together as a team. So especially playing Colby and Bowden, you could see the team really coming together, and we're finally finding passes, working together as a team instead of all the individual efforts.
And this weekend is especially a big weekend.
Yeah.
You're playing St. Norbert next week. You were a transfer from Adrian.
Yep.
What can the Foresters, what do they have to improve upon to play Adrian? We saw a tough battle last week against Wisconsin. What do the Foresters have to do to get ready for Adrian?
Honestly, we just got to focus on ourselves and play our game. We're a very, very fast team. So when we're playing fast, we're moving our feet, we're moving that puck. No one can skate with us. Adrian's a very fast, skilled, and aggressive team. So we just got to make sure we play our own game and not get caught up in the big, oh, we're playing Adrian, what are we going to do? We just need to play Lake Forest College hockey. So.
And so far, 0-0 game, what can the Foresters do to create scoring opportunities? We've seen power plays, but no shot.
Yep. Honestly, crash the net, get pucks in the net, get buys in the net. As long as we got pucks going to the net, something good is bound to happen. So we just got to keep pushing, keep grinding.
And what do the Foresters have to do in the second period? What do you think they need to improve upon, and what do you think they're doing a great job on?
Well, definitely our penalty kill. Claps to our penalty killers, because our penalty kill is probably one of the best in the conference, if not the country. We got to stay out of the box, and we got to keep our feet moving. Like I said before, we're a very fast team. So when we're moving our feet and we're going, no team can beat with us, can compete with us. So we just got to keep our speed up.
And last but not least, what is the difference? You're used to playing. What's the difference about sitting up here and playing? What can you see that you don't normally see on the ice?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Being up here is way different. You kind of get a step back and see the whole picture. When you're on the bench, you're kind of focused on the little details, which is good. But stepping back here, you kind of see it from a coach's point of view, and you see those passes that weren't made or that play that's developing. Whereas in the game, when you're playing, you're kind of just focused on what you're doing and, oh, I missed that stick handle or I missed that shot. But then you see the bigger picture when you step back, and it's just...
Who do you think's going to score first?
I think either Jordan is going to score, or I think Lexi might score. She's been looking pretty good out there, too.
Fast. Both players very fast. Last
Definitely.
Year, Trapp had 3 goals against this team, so you never know.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mackenzie.
Of course. Thank
Get
you.
Well.
Yes.
Well, we want to see you back on the ice, and we want to see you playing.
Thanks, Nat. I appreciate it.
And we will be back shortly. We'll be back for the second period in 11 minutes. Stay tuned. Today we would like to welcome a very special guest, Green Bay, Wisconsin native, number 14 forward, Courtney Wittig, who plays for the University of Wisconsin Eau Claire Blue Golds. Thank you, Courtney, for joining me. So, recently, you were selected as the third round, number 11 overall pick by the Metropolitan Riveters of the NWHL. Mm-hmm. Can you describe what emotion, and you're the first ever player from D3,
yeah.
Can you describe the emotions that you had when they called your name?
I guess when they called my name, I didn't give him the reaction I'm sure he wanted. I just sat there, just kind of blank, staring at him. It didn't feel real, I guess, at first. And then over the weeks, I guess, it just came more, real, I guess. Like, started feeling, I don't even know.
Did you always plan on playing professional hockey after college, or did you have other plans?
I really did not have the thought of it until he really mentioned it to me, and then I really thought, like, oh, yeah, that'd be pretty cool to go to the next level up.
And most of these NWHL players, they have second jobs. Do you plan on focusing on hockey for the first year, or going to grad school, or doing something in between?
I think I'd like to do what most girls do. They have to work a job and then play hockey also.
What sets you apart as a player?
I'd say I'm very competitive.
And if you could compare yourself to any NWHL player or professional player, who would you compare yourself to?
Oh, boy. I have no idea.
And Coach Strand, what distinguishes Courtney from other players?
High compete level. Just very intense player. She's got some speed that's just all of a sudden you think that you know how fast she is, and then she's just gone. So very high hockey IQ also.
And I know you mentioned you were just quoted in a USCHO article. She's good in the D zone. Is she a two-way player?
She's becoming one. Compared to when she first got here, yes, she's taken tremendous strides and really taken a lot more responsibility in our D zone.
Your future Riveters teammate, Kristen Lewicki, was also a member of D3, but she signed as a free agent, and like you, who became the first ever D3 player to be drafted. She played for the Adrian Bulldogs. Lewicki's been in the NWHL for 2 years. If there's one piece of advice, what would it be if you could ask?
I would ask her how it's like going from D3 to the NWHL, the speed and the compete level.
And I know you and I, Coach, spoke earlier. What line do you think she'd be most compatible
with? That's the exciting thing for me to see and watch what they do, because so many of those players are so skilled and high hockey IQ that she can quite frankly go anywhere. She'll be able to play with anybody, and I think on their team and complement what they do.
And that'll do it! Forest Chosen moving on to the semifinals with a score of 5-0. And it'll be a shutout for Jackie Rogers. I'm Natalie Bober, along with Charlie Heckman. Thank you to the Forrester Sports Network. The Foresters will be at Adrian College next weekend, so tune in to see them next weekend. We hope everyone enjoyed the webcast as much as we enjoyed producing it. This is our final webcast for the season. My final webcast as the voice of Lake Forest College women's hockey. That being said, I would like to thank everyone who has tuned in over the past 5 seasons. Your continued support has meant the world to me. It's been a privilege and honor to have been part of this program. One final time from Alumni Memorial Fieldhouse. Foresters 5, Trine 0. We are moving on to the semifinals. We hope everyone has a great evening. Take care.